Hello and welcome to Herald TV News Bulletin with me, Tasleem. The India Bloc candidates in Goa have launched their campaigns with a solemn tribute paying ceremony, honouring the sacrifices of the martyrs at Patra Devi and commemorating the legacy of Ram Manohar Lohia at Lohia Maidan. North Goa candidate advocate Ramakant Khalap and South Goa candidate Captain Viriato Fernandez commenced their campaign for the Lok Sabha 2024 elections.
The India Bloc candidates in Goa launched their campaigns on Monday. North Goa candidate advocate Ramakant Khalap, along with the leaders of India Bloc, paid tribute to the martyrs at Patra Devi Smarak.
या आयटीच्या मार्फत आमका हजारो शेकडो हजारो लाखो भुरग्यांक नोकरी आमका निर्माण करपाक जाय. ते करतले ते करीत असताना ही भूमी राखपाक जाय. यस मैं आगे चल रहा हूं, आप मेरे साथ आइए बंधो.
Later, the leaders along with the South Goa candidate Captain Viriato Fernandez headed towards Margao, where they paid tribute to Ram Manohar Lohia at the Lohia Maidan.
आणि आज जन्ना या वतन इतलो लोक आयलो असा मका दिसता एज रिस्पॉन्सिबल सिटीजन रिस्पॉन्सिबल गोयकार एक एक गोयकाराक एक काळजान सर उजो पेटुल्लो असा की होय गोय सांभाळपाचो टाइम आयलो असा नाले गोय उरपाक ना. हांव तुमच्या कडेन हात जोडून एक विनंती करता सगळे एक जाऊन हे जो पैशाचो जो पॉवर आमच्यात घालूंक सोदता लेट अस मेक इट इन टू अ पीपल्स पॉवर वर्सेस मनी पॉवर.
अ स्ट्रॅटेजी मीटिंग ऑफ द इंडिया ब्लॉक गोवा वॉज हेल्ड इन द इव्हनिंग टू प्लॅन द फर्दर कोर्स ऑफ कॅम्पेन होपिंग टू मेक अ डेंट टू द रुलिंग बीजेपी इन द अपकमिंग लोकसभा 2024 इलेक्शन्स.
सी ह्या लोकसभेक गोयान आमी इंडिया आघाडी इंडिया ब्लॉक अलायन्सा तर्फे हे इलेक्शन आमी लढतात जातून दोनी जाग्याचेर काँग्रेस पक्षान आपले उमेदवार घातल्या. आयच्यान गुढी पाडव्याच्या निमित्तान आमी ऑफिशियल कॅम्पेन आमची लॉन्च केला. आमचे सगळे इतर पक्षाचे वांगडी अलायन्साचे वांगडी सगळ्यांक हांव धन्यवाद करता की आज जी कॅम्पेन आमची पत्रा देवी आणि लोहिया मैदानाचेर जी झाली ती म्हटल्यार इट वॉज अ रियली सक्सेसफूल लॉन्च ऑफ द कॅम्पेन. आणि आता हाच्या मुखार ज्यो आमच्यो मिटींग्स आसात इन रिस्पेक्टिव्ह कॉन्स्टिट्युएन्सीस पब्लीक मिटींग्स डोर टू डोर कॅम्पेन आणि इतर सगळे कॅम्पेन स्ट्रॅटेजीज वी हॅव डिस्कस टुडे. दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट कॉर्डिनेशन मिटींग ऑफ ऑल द अलायन्स पार्टनर्स. टुडे वी हॅव डिस्कस्ड ऑल द स्ट्रीमलायनिंग ऑफ ऑल द कॉर्डिनेशन आणि वी हॅव फॉर्म्ड अ ग्रुप ऑल्सो वेअर सर्टन इश्यूज विल बी टेकन अप जॉईंटली आणि वी विल ट्राय टू रीच टू ईच अँड एव्हरी ऑफ द वोटर ऑफ द गोवा.
ब्युरो रिपोर्ट, हेरल्ड टीव्ही.
वालबे पुलिस हैव अरेस्टेड नासिर हुसैन जमादार रेजिडेंट ऑफ नागवे सत्तरी फॉर स्टोरिंग जेलेटिन एन एक्सप्लोजिव सब्सटेंस इन हिज वेयरहाउस ड्यू टू विच अ ब्लास्ट was reported on Monday night. According to sources, gelatin was stored illegally. Many houses in the vicinity are severely damaged. People have complained that the threat of explosives still continue. Escorting activities in the locality have no control. The affected people have requested local authorities to investigate the case with an angle of sabotage and initiate strict action against all the responsible persons in the case. Gudi Padwa festival was celebrated across Goa with great fervor on Tuesday. Hindus across Goa came together to commemorate the Hindu New Year with houses filled with color and goodies. The melodious sound of dhol and tashe echoed across the state as locals joyously celebrate Gudi Padwa.
Gudi Padwa, which marks the beginning of the new year for Hindus, was celebrated with religious fervor, exchange of greetings and hope across Goa on Tuesday. The festival marks the beginning of Chaitra Navratri and is seen as an auspicious occasion to start new ventures and perform ceremonies. The Gudi Padwa Puja is done early in the morning. People assembled the Gudi together with a bamboo staff, cloth and other flowers. It is believed that the rays of the sun falling on the copper pot bring good health and prosperity to the family.
Oh, Hindu Navavarsha Swagat Karyakram Ya Lohia Maidanache Sampanna Zalo. अनेक वर्षां असो विचार चलतालो की समस्त मठग्रामवासी ह्या नववर्षाचे स्वागत करपा खातीर मडगांवांक एकठांय येवचे ते ह्या वर्साक पूर्ण जाला. युगाब्द 5125 क्रोधी नाम संवत्सर आज सुरू जाता शके 1946 हो शक या आईचा दिस सुरू झाला। सगळ्या समस्त हिंदू बांधवांक विशेषतः मठग्रामवासियांक हांव या गुढी पाडव्याच्यो संसार पाडव्याच्यो नव वर्षाच्यो हार्दिक शुभेच्छा दिता आणि तांचे हे वर्ष सुखी समाधानी तांचे आयुरारोग्य बरे जावचे अशी हांव परमेश्वरा कडेन प्रार्थना करता आणि ह्या संसार पाडव्याच्यो परत एकदा सगळ्यांक शुभेच्छा।
चैत्र शुक्ल प्रतिपदा गुढी पाडवा, तसेच चैत्र शुक्ल प्रतिपदा श्रीराम उत्सव आणि देवी नवरात्र उत्सव असे म्हटले होतात। मित्रांनो, की ज्या वेळार लंकाधिपती रावणाचेर प्रभू श्रीरामान विजय प्राप्त केलो त्या दिसा सबंद भारतवर्षात आणि अयोध्येत ह्या विजयाचे प्रतीक म्हणून गुढी उभारल्यो गेल्यो। त्या दिसापासून हे हिंदू संस्कृतीचे रक्षण करते, हिंदूंचे नवीन वर्ष म्हणून मनवले गेले। मित्रांनो, आज आमची संस्कृती सदोदितीची पाश्चात्य संस्कृतीचं विसर पडचो आणि आमच्या सनातन संस्कृती आणि हिंदू संस्कृतीचे आजच्या नवीन पिढीन रक्षण करचे, आपली संस्कृती फुडें व्हरची, आपली परंपरा फुडें व्हरची। ह्या नवीन वर्षाचो संकल्प करचो की आमी आमची हिंदू सनातन संस्कृती फुडें व्हरतले आणि ती अखंड अविरतपणे चालू करतले। म्हणून ह्या आईच्या प्रतिपदा पाडव्याचे तुमकां माझ्या मना काळजातल्यान शुभेच्छा दिता। सबंद तुमकां आयुष्य आरोग्य मेळचे म्हणून हांव माझ्या मनातल्या तुमकां परवी दिता। देव बरे करू।
द इन्स्टॉलेशन ऑफ रियल टाइम एअर एम्बिएंट क्वालिटी मॉनिटरिंग स्टेशन्स अक्रॉस द सिटी पर्पोटेडली टू एन्श्युअर कंप्लायन्स विथ एअर क्वालिटी ड्यूरिंग स्मार्ट सिटी वर्क हॅज कम अंडर स्क्रुटनी। वॉट इनिशियली अपियर एज अ प्रोएक्टिव मेजर टू अपहोल्ड एअर क्वालिटी स्टँडर्ड्स हॅज नाव सीम्स टू बी अ प्लॉय टू डिसीव द हायकोर्ट। वॉच
Several real-time air ambient quality monitoring stations installed to monitor pollution levels in Panji have been relocated to Don Bosco High School's ground. The move has raised suspicions regarding the true intentions behind the installations, with critics alleging deception aimed at misleading the High Court. The installations were purportedly set up as a part of a collaborative effort between civic authorities and the Pollution Control Board under the guise of monitoring air quality standards around ongoing smart city works. However, just 8 days following the High Court inspection, most of these monitoring stations were found to have been shifted to a location near the Don Bosco School, prompting accusations that the measures were merely a ploy to deceive the court. Sagun Gawde for Herald TV.
Excavation work for drain at Macias Santa Cruz Highway has resulted in massive traffic jams. Currently, the lane heading towards Bambalim has been dug up, for which the traffic has been diverted onto the oncoming lane. Watch. A head-on collision between a two-wheeler and a four-wheeler was reported at Nanoda Kasarpal on Monday late night. Fortunately, no fatalities were reported, but the bike rider sustained severe injuries. The rider was later shifted to hospital for medical treatment. Further investigation is going on, with more details are awaited.
On Monday late night, a head-on collision took place between a bike and a car at Nanoda Kasarpal. As per sources, both parties were on high speed. The road was on an elevated hill, which made the commuters difficult to avoid the collision. The car was driven by a couple. When the driver saw the bike rider approaching him, he lost control of the vehicle and veered off into the bushes. The bike rider sustained major injuries and was later taken to hospital for medical treatment. Police have registered a case and further investigation going on.
Rent-a-car veered off road at a sharp turn, crashing into an electric pole at Anjuna late night on Monday. Despite the major damage to the car and the electric pole, no injuries were reported.
Speed breaker is a must. It's a must at two places. Sharp turns here. Accidents are happening from my childhood and maybe before that also.
On the same road?
Same road. I used to run with pots, water pots, to put water on those
injured
persons.
What do you want to say on the rent a cab accidents? Either start tourist yatat goyan
ma sahat no tourist sang maiti na ya rastyachi maiti na yatat 8 dhisang kharcha kartat ani vetat butlar ami tar speed breaker gali ani tyache vast paint marit tinka tyancha lakshana netel vare baba speed breaker ab yaptu goslo it is the unsense tujhe sangta no
sign boards kinam na
sign boards are there police aje sign board an pahile le ha accident zone ho hai kide म्हटल्यार ते पळय तूं बोर्ड म्हणटा पळय तेजे सेकंडरी द मेन थिंग वी हॅव टू फोकस ऑन स्पीड ब्रेकर विच इज अ मस्ट.
The government of Goa, through the State Disaster Management Authority and Revenue Department, has issued a public notice regarding preventive measures to combat the ongoing heat wave like conditions prevailing in the state. Based on the latest bulletin issued by the Indian Meteorological Department, which indicates sustained high temperatures ranging between 33 to 35 degrees Celsius over the next week, the government has alerted citizens to take necessary precautions.
While the heat remains tolerable for the general population, vulnerable groups such as infants, the elderly, and individuals with chronic illnesses are at a moderate risk of health concerns. Possibilities of dehydration and dry grass catching fire have been highlighted as potential risks during these conditions. Preventive measures advised by the government. In light of these conditions, the public is advised to take the following preventive measures. Avoid prolonged exposure to the heat. Opt for light-colored, loose, cotton clothing to stay cool. Cover the head with a wet cloth, hat, or umbrella when venturing outdoors during peak hours. Ensure regular intake of water to prevent dehydration, regardless of thirst levels. Rehydrate the body with oral rehydration solutions, ORS, or homemade drinks such as lassi, sugarcane juice, or lemon water. Workers are cautioned to avoid direct sunlight during peak hours, and strenuous activities should be scheduled during cooler times of the day. Farmers are advised to continue irrigation activities in crops and vegetables to mitigate the impact of high temperatures. Avoid alcoholic beverages, tea, coffee, and carbonated drinks, as well as high protein or stale foods. Pregnant workers and individuals with medical conditions are urged to take extra precautions.
Bureau report for Herald TV.
Taligaon locals on Monday celebrated annual Dhulwar on Tuesday with great devotion. This traditional festivity, deeply cherished by the community, is part of the Grand Shigmotsav festival, spanning five glorious days. The festivities commence with the melodious Suwari Vandan, setting the tone for days filled with cultural richness and jubilant gatherings, culminating on the auspicious occasion of Gudi Padwa. The final day marks the exuberant Dhulwar celebration, also affectionately known as Rang Panchami.
आमचं वार्षिक पद्धती प्रमाणे शिगमोत्सव जाता.
ओके.
त्या निमतान हो उत्सव 5 दिवस चालता.
ओके.
आणि ह्या उत्सवाची सुरुवात सुवारी वादनान जाता.
ओके.
आणि पहिले 3 दिवस आम्ही सुवारी वादन करता आणि शेवटचे 2 दिवस आम्ही नाट्यपुष्प अर्पण करता. एक सामाजिक नाटक आणि एक संगीत नाटक. आणि त्या संगीत नाटकानंतर जो पाडवो येता गुढी पाडवा, त्या दिसा आम्ही ह्या देवाची दुवट साजरी करता.
Okay.
रंगपंचमी आमची ह्या दिसा असता ह्या ग्रामस्थांची. सो असे करून ह्या उत्सवाची आम्ही सांगता करतो.
वास्को वेटरन्स डिफीटेड बेनावली वेटरन बाय 2-0 ऑन मंडे. वास्को वेटरन्स नाऊ मूव्ड इन टू द सेमी फायनल ऑफ द 20th फ्लेम ऑफ युनिटी स्पोर्ट्स क्लब वेटरन फुटबॉल टूर्नामेंट दॅट वॉज हेल्ड ऍट मबाय ग्राउंड सेराउलिम.
द मच अँटिसिपेटेड मॅच बिटवीन वास्को वेटरन्स अँड बेनावलिम वेटरन्स वॉज हेल्ड ऍट सेराउलिम. Father Frankie and Ramesh of Vasco Veterans were the stars of today's match. Vasco Veterans netted both goals in the second half through Father Frankie and Ramesh in the 45th minute and 60th minute respectively. At the end of the match, Vasco Veterans crushed the Benolim Veteran by 2-0, making it into the semis. Inacio for Herald TV.
In an exciting GFA First Division League match at Rosary Ground, Navelli on Monday, Sao Jose Villarreal Sports Club emerged victorious against Santa Cruz Club of Cavelo C with the 4-2 scoreline. Both strong contenders in the GFA First Division League put on a riveting performance.
The match started off with a ban as Reagan Costa of Sao Jose Villarreal opened the scoring in the 12th minute. However, Sidroy Furtado of Santa Cruz Club quickly equalized in the 21st minute, keeping the match evenly poised. However, Sao Jose Villarreal refused to back down and took the lead once again in the 44th minute, courtesy of another goal by Reagan Costa. It seemed like they had the match in their grasp, until Delson Pasanha of Santa Cruz Club found the back of the net in the 53rd minute, equalizing the score once again. As the match approached its final minutes, Sao Jose Villarreal showed their dominance on the field with 2 more goals. Stalin Oliveira struck in the 80th minute and Ian Matthews Indro sealed the victory in the 89th minute, securing a 4-2 win for their team. That's all we have in today's news bulletin. Thanks for watching Herald TV News. For more news and alerts, please follow us on O Heraldo on Facebook and Twitter. Take care and goodbye.